This shredder has packed up tight on me again. The edges of these cutters, they're not sharp anymore. These points that pull the paper through, they're still sharp. And the job of this plastic is to push these little wedge-shaped pieces of paper out after they've been cut. This one on the end here, the paper keeps jamming in there, and that piece of plastic is chewed up. And this is packing tight again. It's interesting that the paper is not getting packed in any of these other positions, just here and over here on this side. So I'm going to clean this out of here and have a closer look at that one last time. Having this out in my shop, I can get in here and really clean out between these cutters. And you can see the sharp edge here. They're supposed to be pushed together. And here you can see there's quite a space in there. The outside edge of this one's been worn or broken off. And this one has actually been turned in. And then the piece of plastic that's supposed to be in here is partially missing and worn away. You can see this bit of plastic that should be in here like this is missing, and there's been enough stuff packed down in here that it's spread these two apart. This is the quantity of material that was removed from between that one set of cutters. And on the far end, these pieces of plastic were broken and came out, which is over here. That plastic came out of here. And this white piece of plastic can now turn fairly freely on there, and it should not be able to. The plastic over here in the center is turning freely as well. So that's permanently damaged. And somewhere in here, this tooth here is missing, and this one is bent over to the outside. So I would say that's the death of a shredder. It's not much fun having to go in and dig this stuff out every time you use it. When you're shredding old documents, it's real easy to miss a staple, and occasionally you could miss a paper clip. I'm going to guess that those bent and broken teeth, this thing has chewed up a couple of paper clips over the years. I can't think of anything else that would do that kind of damage. Paper by itself will not. Now that I know for sure that it's not worthwhile trying to repair this thing weighs a little over 9 pounds. And we're going to look inside and see how it's made. When I run this, you'll see that this piece is turning and the other pieces of white nylon are not. And the reason it's not turning, each of these pieces of white plastic are supposed to be attached to this ring that's being held stationary by this bar. We can see a piece of nylon over here that's supposed to be attached to this nylon spacer, and this one that was supposed to be attached to this. Both of those have broken off. Inside the cover, everything is held in place nicely with little clips. It's got a little zip tie here, and on the other end, the micro switches are held firmly in place. And then over here, we have this gear train. Some is metal, and some is nylon. And we've got a bunch of grease and metal pieces that are sprayed up here on the top. And all along through here. And under here, there's a circuit board It's got directional controls and where the micro switches and that connect. This is a relay. And if you had one of these that suddenly decided to quit running, opening up one of these and looking inside here, you may find that some of these metal particles have shorted out that board. The motor shaft is attached to a very small helical pinion that's driving this helical gear. And then this is attached to another nylon pinion that's driving the next gear. So again, we have the motor pinion driving this helical gear, which is nylon, attached to a nylon pinion that's driving this nylon gear. And the pinion attached to this appears to be metal. And this is a metal gear attached to these two drive gears for the shredder. So there's quite a bit of reduction in here. Here we can see the armature when the motor's running. And another thing that can wear out in time would be the brushes. On the end of this one cutter bar, we just have a slight reduction to drive these two shafts, which is where you can destroy a CD or a DVD. This is for destroying a CD or DVD, and it does not cut it into pieces like the paper does. This is intended to shred paper or destroy a CD, one or the other, not both at the same time. And the disc goes down in here and it's just forced between these cutter wheels and it slices the CD or DVD in strips. Now it's all taken apart. This is where I get a lot of my screws, springs, retainers and stuff for future projects. Four micro switches. The cutters, once you get this apart, these will come off of here piece by piece. So if you had spare parts, you could repair this. But we don't, so we won't. The gear behind this nylon gear is metal. And they're running on this one, and this is sharp as a razor blade. So that has been lapping the teeth in on this for as long as I've had the shredder. A little grease plus the application of some paper dust is probably a pretty good lapping compound. Looking at the motor a little closer, this does have a little fan on there, very small. And on the other side is a temperature sensor. And so if this thing overheats, this is what shuts down the shredder. This is what's known as reverse engineering, taking something apart that someone else has built to see how it works. Maybe you can make it better, more than likely to see if you can make it cheaper. Now there's two of these fairly clever little deals that were on the shredder. One where the CDs are shredded, and another where a credit card could be shred. And as that CD or credit card would push this down, a micro switch has a spring built into it. So when this is depressed, there's a spring trying to raise it up again. So on this little gadget, this is a bellows. And there's a real small diaphragm right here. So when a CD would go past this or on the other one that had a smaller bellows, that would depress the lever on this thing, and that spring is working against that bellows. So there was a little rocker mechanism here that would push down on this lever. That pushes the air out of the bellows, and then this is a slow delay to keep this contact closed until this finally gets back up to here. So when that CD or credit card would compress that, then this would run the motor long enough for those items to clear the shredder, and then this would turn off the motor.